My dear students, hope you are well and I am also well by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am Mohammad Humayun Kubir, assistant teacher, Milestone School and College, English Medium Senior Section, Sector 7, Uttara, Dhaka. Students, today I will conduct lecture number 44, Practical Geometry, Exercise 7. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to draw a bisector of an angle. Draw 45 degree angle without using a protractor. Draw 60 degree angle without using a protractor. Students, at first we will review our previous lesson, after that we will start our today's lesson. Students, now review. Look at here. There are given a line segment AB. Now we will divide this line segment into two equal parts. Here I will show how we will divide this line segment into two equal parts. So look at here. Here you know this is the pencil compass and this pointer you will set here. A as a center, taking the radius more than half of AB. Okay, so more than half of AB, here you will draw one arc and another arc like this way. Okay, after that, taking the same radius. Okay, now B as a center, draw another two arcs like this way. Okay, understood everyone? Here, now look at here. Suppose these two arc intersect point P and these two arc intersect point Q. Okay, now we will add PQ. Okay, now look at here. Here, suppose this is the D. Okay, look at here. This PQ line segment intersect AB. This point, suppose this point is D. Here AB line segment here. Divided into equal two parts AD and BD. Okay, here AD equal to BD. Here two part AD and BD. These two parts are equal. Okay, these two parts are equal. Understood everyone? I think it is very clear to you. Okay. Here construction 8. Construction of the bisector of an angle. Suppose here given a angle. Now this angle's bisector we will draw. Okay, look at here. There are given a angle BAC. BAC, this is the angle. Now this angle's bisector we will draw. Okay, now here I will show how we will draw this bisector. Now here A as a center, taking the radius, suitable radius. Okay, A as a center, taking the suitable radius, here we will draw one arc. Okay, suppose this arc intersect point E and F. Here, taking the suitable radius A as a center, we will draw one arc. This arc intersect AB at point E and AC at point F. Okay, after that, what will you do? Here, taking the radius more than half of EF. Okay, and E as a center Okay, E as a center, we will draw one arc. Okay, after that, here, taking the same radius, F as a center, draw another arc. Suppose these two arc intersect point here, this point. Suppose this point is D. Okay. Now we will add A and D point. We will add A and D point. Okay. If we add A and D point, then here we will get a line segment AD. Okay, so this line segment is the required bisector. Okay. Now, suppose an angle BAC is given. Here, BAC, this angle is given. We are to draw a bisector of the angle BAC. This BAC angles bisector we will draw. Now, here, step 1. Taking the suitable radius with A as a center. Here, A as a center, taking the suitable radius, we will draw one arc. Okay. We will draw a center, draw an arc that cuts this arc card AB at point E and AC at point F. Okay. So next step what will you do here? Step 2, taking the radius more than half of EF. Here we will take the radius more than half of EF with E and F as the centers. After that, here A and F as the center, draw two arcs here. These are and these are these two arcs in interior of BAC. Interior of BAC that cut each other at point, say here D. Okay. Now step 3, join A and D. Join here in this stage, what will we do? We will join A and D, this point, A point and D point. Then here we will get a line segment AD. Okay. So this line segment is our required bisector. This AD line segment is our required bisector. Students, I think it is very clear to you. Okay. Now, everyone write in your CW copy. Our next number, construction 9. Constructing a 60 degree angle. Here, we will draw 60 degree angle without using protractor. Okay. Now, look at here. Here, how we will draw this angle. At first, we will draw a line. Suppose line PQ. Now here on this line mark a point. This point suppose O. Now what will you do here? Taking the suitable radius, O as a center, here we will draw one arc. Suppose this arc intersect this point here, suppose this point is A. Taking the same radius, A as a center, here
we'll draw another arc. We'll draw another arc. Here, this arc passes through this point, O point, and these two arc, look at here, these two arc intersect here. Suppose this point B. Now, we'll add O and B. We'll add O and B. Now look at here. Here from the angle BOA. Here this angle is 60 degree angle. Here suppose given the measurement of an angle is 60 degree, here given the measurement of this angle 60 degree, we have to draw the angle. Step 1, here in the first step, what will we do? Draw a line PQ. This line PQ we will draw and mark a point O. Mark this point O on the line PQ. On this line PQ, here mark this point O. Now step 2, taking the suitable radius with O as a center, taking the suitable radius and with O as a center, we will draw this arc. And this arc, look at here intersect this point, here this point, suppose this point A. So here with O as a center, draw an arc that cuts PQ at point, this PQ line at point A here. Now in this step, here third step, taking the same radius previous radius with A as a center, this point as a center, draw this arc that passes through point O. This point passes through this arc. Let the two arcs have been intersected. These two arcs have been intersected point this point. Okay, suppose this point is B. Now step 4, join O and B, this point O and B, then the required angle is BOA. If we join O and B, then here look at here we will get an angle BOA, and this angle's measurement is 60 degree. This is our required angle. Our next number 16, page number 156, draw the angle 45 degree without using a protractor. Here without using protractor we will draw 45 degree angle. Okay, now look at here how we will draw 45 degree angle. At first we will take a line. At first we will take a line. Suppose this line ED. Here mark a point on line ED. Suppose here this point is B. Now look at here this is the set square. We use this set square. By using this set square, here draw a perpendicular. Take a point, after that add these two points. If we add these two points, then here suppose A.
Now here AB perpendicular on DE. Okay, this angle ABD, this angle is 90 degree angle. Now we will divide this angle. Okay, so how we will divide this angle? Here, taking the suitable radius, taking the suitable radius, B as a center, B as a center, here, draw one arc. Suppose this arc intersect point, this point here, this point is P and this point is Q. Okay, now P as a center, P as a center, taking the radius more than half of PQ, more than half of PQ, and P as a center, draw one arc inside the angle ABD, and taking the same radius, taking the same radius, Q as a center, draw another arc. Okay, suppose these two arc intersect point C, point C. Now in this stage, at B and C point, if we join B and C point, then here we will get a line segment BC and we will get two angle ABC and CBD. A, B, C and C, B, D. Both angles measurement is 45 degree. 45 degree. Here, suppose the measurement of an angle is 45 degree. Here, given 45 degree, we have to draw the angle without using a protractor. Without using this protractor, we will draw this angle. Okay. So here, first step, step one, draw a line DE. This line we will draw by using the ruler and mark a point B on the line DE. Here, mark a point here, this point on this line DE. This point suppose B. Here, step 2. In this step, what will you do? Draw a perpendicular AB. Here, we will draw this perpendicular AB by using this set square. Okay, by using this set square, here we will draw this perpendicular. Okay, so at point B on line DE by using set square. Now, in this step, here, step 3, third step, with B as a center and taking the suitable radius, here B as a center, taking the suitable radius, we will draw this arc here, PQ arc. Okay, so here suitable radius, draw an arc that cut BD at point P. That cut, that means this arc cut this BD point P and AB at point Q and AB at point Q. Okay. Student, write this. We will write next step. Now step 4. With P and Q as centers. P and Q as centers. Taking the radius more than half of PQ. More than half of PQ. Draw two arcs in interior ABD. These two arc we will draw here that cut each other at point C. Here we will draw these two arc interior ABD and these two arc suppose intersect point C. Now, step 5, join B and C. Join B and C point. B and C point. If we join B and C, then here we will get a BC line segment, and here we will get to angle A, B, C and C, B, D. Both angles measurement is 45 degree. So, then ABC equal to CBD equal to 45 degree.
Students, after this class here we have learned what? First we have learned how to draw a bisector of an angle. Here we have learned how to draw a bisector of an angle, and we have learned how to draw 60 degree angle without using protractor. And another here we have learned how to draw 45 degree angle without using protractor. Okay. OSW number 44, chapter 7, construction 3. Students, I hope you enjoyed this class, and this HW you will do on time and you will submit in time.